collect some trophies. I'm gonna move this mic. I hope that's okay. Next trophy in 15 seconds, so let me know if this music's overbearing, and I'll try to do something about it. I think it's okay, though. I got it. Does anybody remember how to play this game? If so, that's only one of us. Yeah. This game really tests your reflexes in a way that Ultra Bullet can't. I mean, the very end of an Ultra Bullet game compares to this. Yeah, this has actual bullets, so there's that little distinction. Ah! I have to remember not to hold down these keys. It's super easy to hold them down. These controls are, like, ridiculously sensitive. You gotta be pretty careful. Whoa, what did I get? Did anybody see that? I like how the beat keeps pace with the beat music. It's gotta be 120 BPM or something like that. Do. Shit! I was close. I could have been a contender for the best time. I've never been able to dodge one of those sixes or sevens or however many that is. Or that particular pattern. That one's really hard to dodge. Because anywhere you can dodge to, there's something to hit you. Believe it or not, there's part of the game that's very much like this. Perhaps not quite as insane, but pretty up there. This is so intense. I don't think a controller would have helped, though. Some keyboard controls are fine. Not nearly to the extent I need to. him onto something with that. Oh, that's no good. I don't know what to do against that. Being bombarded from both sides at once is not a pleasant situation. Also, this music is much louder than the soundtrack we were listening to earlier, so this has a greater... Whoa, I didn't know I could do that. It's a greater feeling of intensity, even if it isn't necessarily more intense. That one's surprisingly low. Of course I say it's easy to dodge, and then I get hit. I kinda deserve that. That was too risky. Ah! Ah! Oh, I should not have held right there. I was onto something. I walked right into that. Oh, okay. I should have held left there. And I didn't. It's easier to hold when you shouldn't have held and to not hold when you needed to hold. This game's reflexes are just ever so slightly... Oh, its timing windows are too narrow for a person to efficiently pick this up. This is like me playing every chess opening and learning one move at a time from each boss. Oh, that was unfortunate. I mean, sure, eventually I'd learn them all, but there's gotta be a better way. Some permutations of these patterns, like, for a better time than others. Okay. It almost worked. That didn't work. Yeah, I guess when there are two which are perfectly horizontal with each other, dodging between them is pretty terrible. You have to just really super careful with how long you hold the button. It's certainly easier to dodge when they're not exactly on the same horizontal line. Shit, that pattern kills me every time. I should look up how some people dodge that, but where's the fun in that? You don't get any exploration if I just look up the answer. Whoa! Okay. Not cool. Okay, I tried something new there that didn't quite work. By quite, I mean at all. Jeez. That was close. It's like I need to go towards the squares, but just barely miss them. Still getting used to just how fast everything moves and how quickly I can turn around, etc. I keep imagining that I can move horizontally as fast as I can vertically. That simply is not the case. Fuck! That could have been a 10.34 second this time. Probably not more than 10.34. Keep trying. Dude. was unfortunate. Knowing my luck, I would have gotten screwed by something. Oh! I'm slowly picking this up. So there are various trophies based on how long you survive against these things. Next trophy is at 15 seconds. There better be another trophy at 16 seconds to make up for all this challenge. And then another one at 17. I'm just saying. This is hard. It would be nice to get more trophies for like 10 seconds, 11 seconds, 12 seconds, and so forth. I could use all those trophies right about now. I guess they wouldn't want to devalue the more challenging trophies. I could try the game in flip mode. I forget if I beat the flip mode or not, but I think there is a trophy for it. For some reason, after you've beaten the game, then you can unlock flip mode. There's a trophy for beating it in flip mode, which isn't so hard. Assuming you haven't spent, like, hours learning all the levels in normal orientation. And trying to master them and get all the other trophies first. That was no good. Colors change each time the cube passes it. No, that's just time-based. Yellow, green, blue, red, violet, pink, purple, yellow, green, blue, red, or pinkish, violet, yellow, green, blue, red, pink, purple, yellow, green, blue, red, pink, purple, yellow, green, blue, red, pink, purple, yellow. I see the pattern. Plus, apparently, saying all the color names seems to calm me down. Like, I don't feel pressure to talk about anything of substance with the audience. Because, as great as it is playing the game, actually playing and talking, like, engages all sections of the brain at once. And that's pretty intense. Come on! I got that. This game takes my victory. Okay, I walked right into that one. I just wish that, like, whoever this guy is, were a bit more clever about dodging things. Or if he could, like, take an indirect hit. At least, like, absorb some damage that isn't exactly head-on collision. Like, if he sees a square right in front of him, if he could just, like, stop and not, like, if he could refuse my command, just so he doesn't walk straight into a cube, that'd be great. I don't think I'm gonna be so lucky, though. Oh. so I think this is... Unless people want to see more of this, this might be enough. Maybe once I reach 6 seconds, you say that that's the most we can get today, given this attention span. Also, I wonder how this looks like in 30 FPS as opposed to 60. It'd be cool to stream this in 60 FPS, although it might make a lot of noise. But it can't make more noise than the music, so it might be worth trying. Probably by getting lucky with our choice of tiles. So yeah, if somebody's good with math and Poisson distributions, they can probably figure out just how many of these I'm gonna have to get until I get just the right draw that keeps me going through the 6 seconds. Somebody's figured out, like, exactly how long this play session's gonna be, based on, I don't know, we'll assume an average game time of 3 seconds, and a standard deviation of, say, 1. Figure out, using a Poisson distribution, how many minutes I'm gonna be playing this until I, get one that lasts for 6 seconds. I'm guessing the answer is about an hour. Assuming I don't actually learn something or decay through this experience. So, assuming I don't degenerate and I'm able to, like, have the stamina to keep playing this for an hour. Do we think it would take an hour or a half hour? There we go, 6 seconds. Back to the main menu. Okay, we'll check out our trophies. Secret lab. Still flipped. Is this where Trophy Lab's at? No. Complete the game in flip mode. Flip mode complete. Complete the game. Game complete. Oh, I got 2 dinky trophies here. 5 seconds on the Super Gravitron. 10 seconds on the Super Gravitron. 15, 20, 30, 1 minute. Win with less than 50 deaths. 100, 250, 500. Okay, do you think I could win with less than 500? Because I sure don't. Yeah, and then this, complete the game in no death mode. Master of the Universe. Not gonna happen. Oh, damn. I'm sorry, I forgot there were time trial levels. Should we try Space Station 1? That might be an achievable goal. Probably not. Well, there's nothing over here. Is there anything over here? Just these people. Super Gravitron. Intended for entertainment purposes only. Anyone found using the Super Gravitron for educational purposes would be asked to stand in the naughty corner. I'm so glad we got that cleared up. What? so upset. Oh, this is the naughty corner. Wow. I thought of everything. Alright, back to the main menu. Let's see if we can pick a time trial. Play mode, time trials, space... Ooh. Apparently I've completed this in 2 minutes 13. Best rank that they want is an A. How about the final level? I've completed that. Okay, the one I suffered the most with was the warp zone. So, par time of 2 minutes. Jeez. Okay, I'll give this a shot. How do you get through this again? I'm not gonna beat this in hard time the first time through. Ah. Okay. Oops, there's death number one. Death number two. Death number three. Four. Five. I don't think this would be easier with the controller. Wait, what? Where'd the platforms go? Okay, that was weird. Eight. Nine. Oh, there's a death counter right on the screen. How convenient. Oh, this way. Ten. 11. Twelve. Okay, in fairness, I totally deserve that. 13. Not even gonna try for the shiny. Whoa, where am I going here again? This way, then this way. Make you clumsy. Oops. Case in point. Also case in point. Nope, that's no good. Wait, how did I manage to clear this in 5.5 minutes? That feels legendary compared to the pace I'm going at. I must be close to the end. Go. Can I not do this? 40. Well, I didn't need that. One, two, three, go. Oh, gosh darn it. I'm so afraid to hold left there. So afraid to hold left. Well, I am not beating my record. Not that, but, like, can I not flip while I'm holding the left arrow key? Yes, I can. Just need to actually have reflexes. Okay, thank goodness for checkpoints. Oh my goodness! Physics. Physics works so well in this game, to be honest. It doesn't work too good, it's too accurate. It's so fluid that if you're not accustomed with how physics works, it can be jarring. Oh, that was close. Actually, yeah, I do want to take the bottom half. That's no good. Oh, no. I thought I had it. Fuck's sake. Don't hold left there. Unlike everywhere else in the game where holding a direction's cool. It's not easy being green. Green dudes can't flip. There is no green dude. Okay. 70 deaths. Rank F. Alright, let's try that again. This is how it is. This be how it be. Also no good. Ay, ay, ay. That was stupid. That was a death that could have been avoided. That was a checkpoint down there. Right hidden under the word death. Let's flip. Let's flip first. Just imagine that that's easier somehow. Okay. Well, we'll get better at this the more we practice it. I can flip with the up arrow. My goodness. That helps a lot. None of you guys told me about the up arrow. I should have, like, reread the instructions. But regardless, I got it now. So, nothing to worry about. Well, that was dumb. There we go. Yeah, the up and down arrows both flip. You know, I feel like I should use both of those because for some dumb reason I find it easier to keep track of which way I'm flipping. If I use up for flipping upward and down for flipping downward. Let's use both hands for this one, just to confuse matters as much as possible. I didn't have nearly as much trouble with this with both hands last time. Oops, walked right into that. Checkpoint. Yep. Edge gains. There we go. Round gates. To the banks. Or to the back end. I can read. This will make you flip. Twisty little passages. I love you. Ah! That was most unnecessary death. Flip. Not exactly where I was going. Also not exactly where I was going. Okay, I did try to hit the flip key. 1, 2, 3, flip. There we go. That little gap right there is the most aggravating thing ever. Not exaggerating it. Well, okay. I mean, the gap on the right is more aggravating, but at least that one's easy to blame on myself for just being bad at the game. Okay, that one's my fault too, for just being impatient and bad at reflexes. That's just a question of hitting the arrow keys in the correct order. Apparently something I'm not very good at. Have I mentioned that rhythm games aren't my thing? I don't think I have mentioned that. I'm like, for somebody who has so much interest in music, I am not especially rhythmically coordinated. Spend hours practicing rhythm and still struggle with it. Okay, that was bad. That's just me losing, not having an attention span. I can learn to do simple things well. Learning to do more complex rhythmic things is pretty challenging. I think that holds for everybody. Oh, crap. Okay, I've lost my patience with this. We're going back and trying a different time trial. Start game, play modes, time trials, space station 1. How hard could this be? Well, I almost died right there. That would have been pretty spectacular, wouldn't it? Hey, look. I died to the first creature. into the third one. And now the second one. We're going for like a complete hit all the creatures run. If I played it in normal mode. I'm so flipped out by the notion of this being in flip mode. Okay. Hey, plus one rank. Nice. Oh, do the shiny trinkets give you plus one rank regardless of your time? Because if so, I just took a C to an A by collecting both of them. I don't know. Regardless, that's quite the achievement. Pretty happy with that. Yeah. I don't want to continue on a lot longer here, but I'm not sure what else I'd want to do tonight. Maybe tomorrow morning I'll pick something up. We'll see. Anyway, hope the music hasn't been totally overwhelming. Yeah, hope you enjoyed this playthrough. Figure out what to do next time. So yeah, thanks for watching, and have a good night.